Okay, so for this video, I wanted to do something different. Instead of giving you a list of features that are only available in DaVinci Resolve Studio, like most videos do on this topic, well, instead of doing that, I've been importing some of my old videos in DaVinci Resolve Studio. Videos that I made a few years ago with the free version of DaVinci Resolve. A few commercials, cinematic sequences, you know, things like that. Because I wanted to see if maybe there are things that would have been easier or faster if I had Resolve Studio back then. So that's what I'm gonna show you, because I feel like it could help you to decide if you should upgrade to Studio or not. And it will also give you a better idea of what Studio features could actually be useful to you in real life, because these are real life use cases. Simple use cases, of course. You know, nothing crazy, nothing super difficult. We're not making movies here, obviously. We're making videos, right? And then at the same time, I also want to inspire you and motivate you and show you what the free version of Resolve is capable of, and that you don't necessarily need all those fancy studio features. There's almost always a workaround, even if you have very limited experience, because I made all of these videos as a complete beginner. I was still learning everything. These are literally my baby steps beginner videos. But I'm still super proud of the results. And I know for a fact that each and every one of you can make videos like this. Maybe even better. No matter what gear you have or how much experience, you can all learn this. So I'll link the behind the scenes of how I shot these videos in the description. I did everything in the attic or on a desk with super basic gear. So, you know, no excuses. And if I hear excuses, I might even come over there and give you a kick in the butt. Yeah. But anyway, so here's the first video, edited and color graded in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. On my old and slow laptop, by the way, so also keep that in mind. Okay, and this is what the timeline of that video looks like. And yeah, okay, it looks messy, but like I said, I was still learning. And I mean, these days it still looks messy sometimes, but it looks more complicated than it actually is. Down here are all the sound effects and music. Nothing that Resolve Studio would have done better, but up here maybe. So basically everything you see here are just video overlays, the smoke, the particles, and here that burn transition, also a video overlay. And then here, some speed ramps, some digital zooms. Again, nothing that Resolve Studio would have done better or faster, in my opinion. Except maybe here at the end. Here you can see that the smoke is going behind the bottle and the glass, right? That's because I masked out the glass and the bottle. Now, I did it very basic, just circles. That was just laziness, I think. I should have done it manually, you know? Go over the edge of the bottle and the glass. But yeah, I didn't. But you can do all that in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. Now, are there DaVinci Resolve Studio features that would have made it easier or faster? Magic Mask, that's what you're thinking, right? Well, honestly, first I thought, this is probably too difficult for Magic Mask because of the glass, you know, the transparencies, it's just gonna flip out. But no, actually it does it surprisingly well here. You do have to play around a bit with the blue lines and the red lines, you know, add and remove areas. But what you get is a pretty accurate mask, actually. Now, would Magic Mask have saved me hours of work back then? No, maybe 5 minutes. But if you have to do a lot of masking all the time, then Magic Mask could be very, very useful. But when it comes to editing this video and getting the result that you just saw, there's not much that DaVinci Resolve Studio could have done better or faster, in my opinion. I mean, yeah, actually that's not true. Because I remember back then, 3 years ago, I shot this with the Canon R5, right? In 10-bit 4K. And the free version of Resolve didn't recognize those 10-bit files. So I had to transcode all those files to ProRes. And it literally took me hours on my slow laptop. So if you absolutely need 10-bit support so that you can edit your 10-bit files straight away without having to transcode them, you're gonna have to buy DaVinci Resolve Studio, in most cases. The free version does recognize some 10-bit codecs, but not all of them. Definitely not all of them. And then there's also rendering the video, right? Well, I remember it took me back then, 3 years ago, on my slow laptop, I think half an hour, 45 minutes for like a 30-second video. I tried it again now and it took a minute. But that's not just because of DaVinci Resolve Studio, of course. It's a combination of Resolve Studio, which gives you more hardware acceleration, and my Mac Studio that I have now, which is so much faster than my old laptop. Okay, now before I show you the next video, maybe you're already feeling a creative itch, you want to create something? Well, then you're going to need music, and I get my music from Audio, the sponsor of this video. And Audio not only offers great music, from epic cinematic to intimate folk, and even sound effects, but they're also constantly building, adding new features to make it easier for you to find the perfect song. An accurate filter system, easy to navigate playlists and categories, and even AI. And right now, if you get a lifetime subscription, you get lifetime sound effects for free. So you'll never have to pay for music or sound effects ever again. And you can use everything for personal and client work. It's the first time they're doing this, giving you sound effects for free, so go check it out. You can find the link and my code in the description. And as always, thank you so much, Audio, for supporting my channel. Okay, next video. And again, same as before, made on my desk in the attic, struggling, making mistakes, learning. Good times. So again, when it comes to editing this video, there's nothing crazy going on. It's all about rhythm and cutting to the music. The only difficult part here was removing the strings that I attached to the Tic Tac box. Now, the way I did it was by just covering them with white. It's just a PNG even, of a white background. Because the background was white and, you know, and then I manually keyframed that white image so that it keeps covering the strings. I could have actually done it with the string removal tool, which is also available in the free version, but because the strings are barely visible, I'm not sure if it would have been easier. And in the studio version, well, there's the patch replacer tool. That also works really well. But again, I don't think it would have been easier or faster or better. Everything moves so fast anyway, and the string is barely visible that I think Resolve would struggle doing it automatically. So you always have to do some manual fine-tuning, you know? Now, something that would have been super useful here and only available in Resolve Studio is noise reduction. Because I recorded this in 120fps slow motion. And because I didn't have enough light, I had to boost my ISO. So if you look closely, it's pretty noisy. Now, usually it doesn't bother me that much, but here, because it's an ad and it's such a clean, minimalistic white look, I don't know, some noise reduction would have made it better, I think. Cleaner. But what would really make this video better is not Resolve Studio, but, you know, my own hands-on creativity on location. It all looks a bit too plain, too white. There's no depth. So I should have done something with the background. Different background, maybe some texture, maybe I should have used a green screen even, I don't know. And then also the lighting is very flat. So yeah, Resolve Studio wouldn't have made this video better. It's my own creativity and my own knowledge about lighting and backgrounds and, you know, filming. That's what would have made this video better. Resolve Studio, great, useful, but not a necessity. Okay, and then the final video, my poker B-roll. Inspired by Peter Lindgren's poker B-roll, I had a lot of fun making this, all by myself, by the way. I did everything myself, I filmed myself, and a lot of the camera movements are real, so not done in post. Well, just watch it first, and the link is in the description of the behind the scenes video. And you know what, guys? This video is even simpler than the two before. It's basically hard cuts, some speed ramping combined with music and sound effects. Nothing that would have been easier or faster in Resolve Studio. What could have been better, in my opinion, is the color grading. But you don't need Resolve Studio for that. You just need to learn how to color grade. And then also the lighting. And I don't mean more or more expensive lighting. No, again, just a better understanding of lighting, more knowledge. I was still learning back then. It doesn't look as cinematic as I wanted it, you know? Maybe also some haze would have helped. So again, creativity on location and knowledge about lighting, backgrounds, that's what would make this video a lot better, not Resolve Studio. Now, that being said, I do think that if I would make this video again, I would play around a bit with some effects that are only available in Resolve Studio to create a more gritty cinematic look. That's what I'm feeling right now. Not to fix my bad lighting or anything, no. In addition to better lighting and color grading, effects like halation, analog damage, film grain, that's what I'm feeling here. But that's of course super subjective, and you don't need all those things to create cool, fun videos, not at all. I hope I showed you that. The most useful part about Resolve Studio, in my opinion, is the time-saving aspect. Not having to transcode 10-bit files, for example. But also having a faster computer helps with the time-saving aspect. You know, back then, 3 years ago, on my slow laptop, I had to create proxies because that laptop was way too slow to edit 4K video. You know, and it all slows down your workflow. But yeah, so I just wanted to show you that Resolve Studio is great and it has a lot of very useful features, but it's not a necessity. If you can't afford it, don't worry. Your creativity, that's what makes great videos. And there's always workarounds to do what Resolve Studio does in the free version. So don't worry, be creative, create stuff. That's the most important thing. Okay, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.